हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल वेल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सम रिवीजन फॉर FA1 एग्जामिनेशन। सो फर्स्ट आई टेल यू द कोर्स ऑफ आर सब्जेक्ट एंड देन आई प्रोवाइड यू सम काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, I mean to say paper style type. So first, chapter 1, chapter 5th and chapter 7 from history. Then chapter 8, 9 and 12 from civics. See, again I tell you, from the history part, chapter number 1, Rise of British Rule in India, chapter 5th, Movement towards independence, and chapter 7, post-independence India. Then, from the civics part, chapter number 8, framing of constitution and its feature, chapter 9, fundamental rights, fundamental duties, and directive principle of state policy. And then, chapter 12, Indian democracy. Then, from the geography part, chapter 17, natural vegetation, chapter 20, disaster management, and chapter 14, India location, geological structure, and physiography too. So, total 9 chapters are there in your FA1. So now I tell you about the paper style. If you want to note down, then you can, or else yaad rakhna, but preferable hai ki aap note down kar lo. So section A, so total 40 marks ka paper hai. Then, first section, I mean to say section A, answer the following objective type question as I ask, 8 marks, 1 mark for each question, like match the following, MCQ, fill in the blanks, okay? Join the pair or match the pair, MCQ, fill in the blanks, or true false. Then section B, answer the following question in short, 2 marks each, total 8 marks. Section B, answer the following question in short, 8 marks, 2 marks each. Then answer the following question in brief. Total 12 marks, 4 questions, 3 marks for each question. Then answer in detail. 12 marks, 3 questions, 4 marks each, and 1 question came from the map. My feeling. So now you all clear about the course and paper style. Course mein chapter 1, 5, 7, 8, 9, 12, 14, 17, 20. In paper style, total 40 marks. Section A, 8 marks, objective type question. Section B, answer in short, 8 marks, 8 plus 8, 16. Section C, answer in brief, 12 marks, 4 questions. And section D, answer in detail, 12 marks, 3 questions. So total 40 marks. Okay? Good. So, from today's lecture to the FA1, sorry, from today's lecture till the FA1, we're doing only a revision. So today we are start a revision of chapter number 7, because मैं फ्रॉम द मैनी अ टाइम्स हमने वो चैप्टर देखा ही नहीं है. बिकॉज इन जियोग्राफिक चैप्टर 14, 17 एंड 20 वेरी ईजी चैप्टर, देन इन सिविक्स पार्ट चैप्टर 8, 9 एंड 12 ऑल्सो ईजी. सो वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द हिस्ट्री पार्ट. सो स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 7 रिविजन पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस इंडिया. सो कम टू द पेज नंबर 55. Sorry, come to the page number 47. Chapter 7, Post Independence India. And I tried to cover whole chapter revision in one lecture. So, zyada time bhi na aur aap bhi boring na ho. So, in this chapter, talk about the framing. Two major problems at the time of framing the Constitution of India and put in the end of the sovereignty of British Empire on the princely state and merging of them into making an intact India. Then merger of Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir in detail information. We have seen, don't worry. Then merger of French and Portuguese colony. Then merger of Diu, Daman and Goa. Formation and reorganization of Indian state. So, in this topic, there is a four division after the unification and mergers, princely states were divided. So, classification of state, class A. Then classification of state, class B. Then classification of state, class C. And classification of state class D. Then map given here for the state and the union territories of India. Arre yaar, just a second. Then regionalism. In regionalism, there is a detailed information given about the three main language, caste and religion. There is a three main important factors for create a regionalism. So then regional inequality, then scientific and technological development, and name given the woman and a field also, and then chapter over. So now finally we start the revision topic by topic. So first point here, the article for India's independence was passed in British Parliament in the year 1947. And according to that article, both the countries are got in existence. And at that time, there were two problems before the country framing the Constitution of India. And the second one is to put end to the sovereignty of British Empire on the princely state and merging them into making an impact India. So there is a, I told you, two major problems. Then at that time there were 562 princely state, 48 state had stack in total area of India, and 20% of India's population resident in this princely state. Mostly three states were very big from all the princely state: Kashmir, Hyderabad and Mysore. Then so many of princely state not agree for the join the intact to making an intact India, but the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel convinced all the kings and nawabs of princely state they should voluntarily forsake their respective state in the interest of the subjects and union of India, and finally stimulate the nationalism, and king, rajwadas, nawab contribute in the making of strong, integrated and prosperous India. And Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel assured about to protect the rights and interest. Then all the princely state accepted this instrument except Jammu, Kashmir, Hyderabad and Junagadh, and other states joined the Union of India. So out of 562, 559 princely state accepted and joined the Union of India, and remaining three, Kashmir, Hyderabad and Junagadh, not accept that instrument of accession and not join the Union of India. So then the merger of Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir not needed now seen in detail, because we have very perfectly learned about this in detail, and also we do a revision at the time of these chapters. So now it is not need to revise again, and it is very easy. Then merger of French and Portuguese colony. So in this topic many date information like a numerical, and also some words which is important. So I tell you, you just underline. First, India emerges independent and sovereign on 26 January 1950, but the certain colonies of French and Portuguese were still under their control, and kaun si uske control mein thi. So that is a control under the Portuguese, and is a Diu, Daman, Goa, and control under the French is the Pondicherry. So French control the Pondicherry and Portuguese control the Diu, Daman and Goa. Then merger of Diu, Daman and Goa. So on the 15 August, see, other information is also important, but I covered only this, and also important this Hind Chodo slogan. Then Liberation Army had taken over the administration in their hands on 13 July 1954. All this important. Then merger of Diu, Daman and Goa. So on 15 August 1947, political leaders and satyagrahis entered into Diu, Daman and Goa. In Free Goa agitation, thousands of volunteers died, and start Operation Vijay to liberate Goa. And on 18th December at midnight, Portuguese Governor de Silva surrendered to Indian government, and finally Indian Army captured the Goa, Daman and Diu, and hoisted the Indian flag there. Then on 12th March, Goa, Dadra Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu were merged with Union of India, and these states were known as Union Territory. So thereafter, Silvassa was made the capital of Dadra Nagar Haveli. Then Daman was made the capital of Diu and Daman, and Panji was made of the capital of Goa. Then formation and reorganization of Indian state. Before start this topic, I give you 2 to 3 minutes for read the Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir, because only one paragraph for each state. So you just read it and underline important points, you know about it. And still, if you have any doubt, then you can ask me through comment. I explain in next lecture. So now you have 1 minute for each state. So total 3 minutes. So complete the reading of Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir. Then we'll start the revision of next topic. So first Hyderabad. Read this. Okay, done. Hyderabad done. Then in Hyderabad, the last three line is important. Ultimately, Hyderabad was merged with the Union India by using police force on 18 September 1948. Then Sardar Patel assured the Nizam to protect all their interests. Kanhaiyalal Munshi played a very crucial role in entire episodes. Then information is important. Now, the Junagadh, 1 minute for Junagadh. Not needed, 30-40 seconds only. Underline the Arzi Hakumat point. Okay, done. Then Nawab of Junagadh fled on Pakistan, but on 9th November, referendum of people of Junagadh was taken and Junagadh merged with India. Now Kashmir. So 1 minute for Kashmir. In this topic, important topic is Raja Hari Singh requested for military then against Pakistan attack. Then government of India insisted that the Raja Hari Singh Baddha should first sign the instrument of accession, and then Indian Army could be signed. These all points are very important in this topic. So underline that, okay? Okay, done. Good. So now moving on, formation and reorganization of Indian state. So in this topic, there is important is these four types of classification: class A, B, C, and D. Which state and city were included? I mean, in which class? So Mumbai, Assam, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Madras, Odisha, West Bengal were included in class A. Then Jammu Kashmir, Hyderabad, Mysore, Central India, Rajasthan, Saurashtra, Travancore, Cochin and Papsu, which is Patiala and East Punjab, included in class B. Then Ajmer, Bhopal, Coorg, Delhi, Bilaspur, Kutch, Himachal Pradesh, Tripura, Manipur and Vindhya Pradesh included in class C. And Andaman Nicobar Island were included in class D. And other information from this two paragraph, you just read it. 30 seconds for each paragraph. Fast read and done this topic. Okay, first, see, Assam, Meghalaya, Manipur, Tripura, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram and Nagaland, land of seven sisters. Underline and also underline the paragraph before this para. Finally, central government met to separate state to the region of Saurashtra and Kutch. Then also underline this 14 state included. Then there was a continuous demand for the formation of separate small state like Jharkhand was separated from Bihar, Chhattisgarh was separated from Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand was separated from UP, etc. Okay, done. Still you have 30 seconds. अपने आप से read कर लो, कुछ इतना भी tough नहीं है. और underline करना ये 7 union territories. Okay, done. So now, come to the next page. So here we given map which state the state and the union territories with state capital. Ladakh mein le, जम्मू कश्मीर में श्रीनगर, हिमाचल प्रदेश में शिमला, पंजाब विद द कैपिटल ऑफ चंडीगढ़, राइट? सो लाइक दिस ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड कैपिटल ऑफ पर्टिकुलर स्टेट्स गिवन इन दिस मैप. सो मेक दिस मैप इन योर मैप बुक. सेम टू सेम बनाना है, सो कुछ न्यू नहीं है. Then regionalism. So, India is a unity in diversity, we all know. In which the many people following a different religion, speaking different language, also belonging from the different caste, race, cultures. So that's why we can say that they are country is unity in diversity. So no other country in the world has such a diversity as India has, right? So, इज अ मेन फैक्टर्स, इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्टर्स क्रिएट ओरिजिनलिज्म इज द लैंग्वेज, कास्ट, रिलीजन. सो यू रीड दिस पैराग्राफ, देन विल टॉक अबाउट द लैंग्वेज, कास्ट एंड रिलीजन. So now you have 10 seconds left. Okay, so language. So language stimulates the regional. Many a people speak Hindi, then Gujarati, then Marathi, Telugu, different types of language in India. So many a people speak Hindi in North India and non-Hindi in South India, and they demand new religion according to their language. So State Reorganization Commission already implemented the recommendation of division of region as per the linguistics barrier, I mean to say languages barrier. Then caste and religion. So people belonging from different religions and live in India. So for example, Nagaland, Mizoram, Manipur have a different customs, tradition, lifestyle and profession. So border people in Assam have been demanding at a different region. Therefore, the storming movements have been taken. Then Ulfa terrorism activity in Assam, Punjab and Haryana was separate because of regionalism. So like this, due to this reason, a same way many a state separate from different states. Then regional inequalities. In this topic, not like a revision at points because paragraph is diye hai, so kuch itna nahi hai. So you just go through this two paragraph and moving to the next topic, kuch itna nahi hai, so you just read it. 30 seconds for each paragraph. Okay, done. And science and technical development. So this table is very important. Janki Amba were played a very noticeable role in a flora field, I mean to say vegetation. Then Azima Chatterjee in chemistry field, Indira Ahuja in medicine field, Shankuntala Devi in mathematician and in human computer. And as you know all, abhi inke upar puri web series aayi thi, Shankuntala Devi, right? Then Kalpana Chawla in a astronaut, Sridhar William was also astronaut. So here we done this revision of this chapter. Many a paragraph and topics we don't cover because usme sirf bade bade paragraph the. So I give you for the self reading because itna important nahi tha. So in one lecture we covered the whole revision of this chapter. I hope you all understood and enjoy. So like this, we have done revision of, we will doing a revision of all the chapters for FA1. So in every lecture we have, in every lecture we'll doing a one chapter revision. Okay, and from the today's I don't give you a होमवर्क बिकॉज यू स्टार्ट प्रिपरेशन फॉर द FA1 एग्जाम. सो हियर वी डन टुडेज लेक्चर. गुड बाय एवरीवन. एंड प्लीज स्टार्ट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ प्लीज. अदरवाइज आई गिव यू होमवर्क अ लॉट. सो बेटर है कि आप अपने आप से रीड करो.